Okay, so you got a chance to sit down with him, and yes. It's a 10-minute interview. So here it is. It's the Gin Blossoms, and
Ego.
Here we go. We've got Robbie Wilson on the line from the Gin Blossoms. So exciting to have you. We're calling you. It's 11 p.m. We're calling you at your home. We're interrupting you late at night, but it's such an honor for you to take our call. Thanks for taking the call, man.
My pleasure, Nico. Good evening to you. We're really looking forward to coming to Manila in a couple of weeks.
Yeah, and you know what a journey it has been for you guys to be here. Your fans have been waiting, you know, such a long time to see you guys perform live again. I was just talking to a good friend of mine who said he saw your band perform a couple of years ago in the States, and ever since it was announced, he's had his ticket and he's been waiting. I mean, it's kind of been that mood for a lot of your fans here in the Philippines.
That's wonderful. We've only recently, in recent years, discovered that we have so many fans in the Philippines. So we're very excited to be able to come back and perform for you all again.
Yeah, well, it's been, you know, a lot of years for us just waiting and singing your songs and just anticipating you guys being here. And can you talk to us?
That's what I do, too. That's all I do is wait and sing our songs. That's amazing. We have the same life.
Well, except you sing a little better than I do. Just a little, but...
I'll take your word for it, but, you know, maybe when we get there, you can sing me something.
Maybe let's not. I felt better when you said you'd take my word for it. I would rather not put it to the test.
All right, fine.
Okay. Well, Robin, you know, talk to us a little bit about coming over here and, you know, being in the same show as Sugar Ray and Smash Mouth. I mean, that's going to be crazy, right?
Well, it won't be too crazy. We've been doing it all summer, so we know those guys really well. We're really close friends. It's going to be very exciting for all three of our bands to be together so far away from home. We've had a wonderful tour this summer with the three of us, and we've all gotten to be very close, and we've had a lot of interaction on stage and a lot of interaction backstage. And after the show and on the buses, we're all really good friends. So this is going to be super fun for us to be there in Manila doing a big, exciting show at Araneta Coliseum. And doing that together in the Philippines is going to be really special for all three bands. Oh. And I'm sure that everyone there is going to enjoy seeing Smash Mouth and Sugar Ray. They're both excellent performers. And together we put on a great show together.
Oh, I'm sure. You know, I've heard nothing but great things, and we're really so stoked. I can't say it enough. Have you heard anything at all about the Philippines? Do you have any sort of expectation about what it's going to be like when you guys visit?
Well, we were there a few years ago, and
yeah.
So I have a fairly good idea of what to expect, at least in Manila.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm looking forward to it. I'm wishing that we would be able to spend more time there. It's going to be a very quick trip for us. I think we'll be in the Philippines for less than 48 hours. But it will be very exciting for doing the big, exciting show. And then we're going to have a party with Sugar Ray and Smash Mouth. So we'll be looking forward to seeing our friends and catching up with them. Although, actually, this week we're playing with Sugar Ray in Biloxi, Mississippi.
Ooh.
So I'll be able to see those guys there. And, of course, the main topic of conversation is going to be how excited we are to go to the Philippines together.
Oh, that sounds great. Any standout memories from you, though, from the last time you were here?
Well, I have many. I really enjoyed the food. I really enjoyed the people. we were on the TV show. God, I can't remember the name of it, but we had a blast going on that TV show. I spent a lot of time at the mall, and I made a lot of friends there at the mall. I really couldn't leave the hotel without being recognized, and I really enjoyed meeting everyone there when I was in Manila. And I remember I went to see one of the Harry Potter films with my security guard, and
that was crazy.
That was fun because he had never seen any of the Harry Potter movies, and I made him go with me. And they wouldn't let me go by myself. They insisted I took my security guard, Chuck. So anyway, I'm hoping I get to see Chuck again, and if anybody knows him, tell him I said hello. And we had a great time when we were in Cebu. I think one of my favorite memories was being at the pool in Cebu, and I'm just sitting at the pool by myself relaxing, and three children, approximately 8 or 9 year old children,
right,
came up to me at the pool and started singing As Long As It Matters.
No way.
Really shocked. I couldn't believe that these kids knew the song, and they knew it so well. And nothing like that's ever happened to me in the United States. So that's a standout memory for me. And you can bet that we'll be performing As Long As It Matters when we get to Manila.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. You know, it's actually very funny because I just finished my radio show here. It's 11 in the morning here. We do the morning show 6 to 9 a.m. And every Wednesday, we have something called playback. And I had a 13-year-old girl call me and ask for, till I hear it from you. She was on her way to school, and she was begging that I play it before she entered school.
That's sweet. That's really sweet. Well, recently we had some fans from the Philippines at some of our shows. Here in the United States, and they always ask for that song. So we know we're going to be playing it, and we're looking forward to it.
It's going to be my personal quest as well, Robert, to find Chuck and to make sure
all
to
right.
update him on all the Harry Potter movies to have topics of conversation with you.
Well, I'm assuming at this point that Chuck went back and watched all of the other previous Harry Potter movies. At least that's what it, you know, we had talked about, and he said he was going to, so I'm relying on him to have done that.
You turned him on to Harry Potter. You know, speaking of the food, one of our listeners also wanted to ask me this, just tweeted me this, wanted to find out if there's a favorite dish that you like, whether it's Filipino or anything else, because she says she wants to cook for you. I mean, this is how crazy your fans are here. They're waiting in their kitchens wanting to know what you want cooked for you.
Wow, that is nice. Well, how about a barbecue chicken pizza?
Ooh, we can do that. We can do that. We can give you a little bit of
barbecue chicken pizza with some ricotta cheese, please.
Yeah, a little bit of adobo flakes on it just to give you some Filipino flavor.
That's perfect, yes.
That sounds good.
That sounds great. And then, of course, I'm going to need a side of rice or noodles.
Oh, fantastic. So, if there's one thing you've got a lot of, it's rice. You got to get your belly ready for a whole ton of rice when you make your way over.
I ate every conceivable variety of rice when I was there last time. So.
Oh, and we got more.
But that's the least of it. You know, mostly I remember enjoying the people. It was really nice to meet all of our fans there who had been waiting for us to come over for so long. And I was really struck by how polite and sweet and friendly everyone was. And it's really a beautiful country, and I'm really looking forward to it.
Yeah, and everyone here is fairly quiet up until the night that you guys come over and play, because we're all saving our voices to sing along for when you guys take the stage.
That makes sense. Yeah. drink lots of lemon and honey tea. That'll help with your voices. Get them ready.
There you go. Robin, I don't want to keep you way too long, but a lot of your fans very happy that they're hearing you, talking to them here on Philippine Radio. Anything you want to say to them, you know, get them a little bit more excited for your show when you guys fly over?
Well, just know that Smash Mouth and Sugar Ray are great acts. We're going to have a great show, and we, all of us in the Jim Lawsons, are so grateful to all of our fans in the Philippines. We love you, and we cannot wait to perform for you on the 21st of October.
And neither can we. I mean, you guys are fantastic, but, you know, I'm sorry, we're just going to have to sing along with you. And if that takes the song a little bit off key, then that's going to be our bad. But, you know, for writing and performing, you know, incredible tracks of our lives from all your fans. Thank you very much. We can't wait to see you, man.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me on your show and helping us promote the concert. And as I said, I'll be looking forward to seeing you all in just a few weeks. So thank you, Nico.
Sweet, man. Thank you very much. I'm going to let you get some rest.
All right. Have a great night.
All right. See you.
All right.
Good day.
Kilig. That was Nico, and of course, the lead singer of...